this tutorial, we will see an introduction to using the regrade HDR merge effect. Normally, this sort of effect is used to combine a series of different exposures of the same scene into a single high dynamic range scene. Within the HDR Merge plugin, we have two modes called HDR Merge and HDR Blend. HDR is high dynamic range, and the modes are called Blend and Merge because those are the algorithms used in merging a stack of different exposures. We will see the normal use in this tutorial and then see some examples of more creative uses in the next tutorial. In this first example, we can see a typical normal use for HDR merge. We can shoot the same scene with multiple exposures and take the shot with all the highlight details preserved and another shot with all the dark or shadow details preserved. We have them stacked here as two tracks. You can see that we have a very bright exposure and a very dark exposure where there's no detail. If we add HDR merge and choose blend and make the dark shot the second source to blend the two sources, we can get the best of both and get an increased bit depth by combining them. Now we have the brightest highlights and the darkest shadows all in one shot. We can manipulate the midpoint and spread values to control the result. In this example, we're going to use another plugin in the regrade suite called Contrast Enhance. HDR Merge is part of Contrast Enhance, as you will see. Our source in this case was shot on a Sony camera and is Sony RAW format. It's their higher dynamic range RAW format. If you have a RAW format like ARW or RAW or one of the other RAW formats, then you will start by right mouse clicking and going to Interpret Footage, Main, More Options, and that takes us to Adobe Camera Raw. In our original image, our problem is that the sky is all washed out. I can turn the exposure down to minus 1.5. I can do that because I have higher dynamic range available. I can select OK and we return to After Effects. So now we can see some detail in the sky, but it's way too dark everywhere else. I can apply Regrade Contrast Enhance. This brings the rest of the image back, but the sky is washed out again. So I can go to Tone Remap and select HDR Merge, which will then merge the sky from the previous correction with the result from Contrast Enhance. Now we have the best of both. To recap, we created two images from the original image, taking advantage of the high dynamic range, and then we combine them to get the best of both. In this next example, we're working with two exposures of video. We have this shot from a RED camera, and we'll go to Interpret Footage, Main, More Options. The RED camera has this proprietary process that they call HDRX. It works by recording two exposures within the interval that a standard motion camera would only capture one. Since HDRX shoots two exposures, we have this option, HDR Track, where we see track 1 and track 2, one being the light track and two being the dark track. We choose one and duplicate the footage and choose two for the other one. Now we have the light exposure and the dark exposure represented for each track. We can add HDR Merge for tone remap. We choose HDR Blend and choose track 2. We always choose blend for a double exposure as it takes the brightest value from one image and the darkest value from the other image and creates a curve based on those values. You can use the midpoint adjustment to control the result to the desired look. Now we have the best of both and I've generated a higher dynamic range clip. This example was shot with a Canon camera using Magic Lantern firmware, which allows sequential exposure in a video file. One frame is high exposure and the next frame is lower exposure. This is also referred to as dual ISO. So in a shot like this, you might have sunlight outdoor and want to see the green of the trees, but still have details in the foreground that you want to maintain. By having the two exposures, we can add HDR Merge and choose HDR Blend for the tone remap option, choosing the other exposure as the source. This last example is shot all outdoors and also with a Canon with Magic Lantern firmware. These are the two different exposures alternating. As the exposures are sequential, if we just duplicate the clip and offset by a frame, it will not be time aligned, so you'll get a ghosting when things move. One way to deal with this is we apply deflicker auto levels on each layer. With filter out frames, keep odd frames only on top, and keep even frames only at bottom. We can add HDR merge again, and we make the alternate exposure as the source using HDR blend. Now we can also adjust the saturation. Now you've seen an introduction to different ways of using HDR merge for combining exposures and getting the best results.